So my topic is about the economic and social causes of environmental damage.
And my question is, will the economy and human lifestyles be the inevitable cause of environmental damage?
Not working.
So background information is urbanization, and that's decreasing number of people that live in urban areas like cities. And consumer sovereignty is the desires and needs of consumers control the outputs of producers. So what we want is what producers make, and that's what drives it. So why it matters that we use Earth resources as unlimited without thinking about the current world climate problems. And it's an understanding question because we don't, like I said, we don't really think about it. We don't really get these factors and actually see how it contributes to the climate. So my thesis is that economic growth and wants of consumers involves manipulating the natural world affecting the environment in three ways. And the first way is the current economy benefits few at the expense of many. So when you think about the economy and wealth is mostly from very wealthy countries and it's from very wealthy people, and when that happens it's usually from making something or building something or innovating something. When that happens it's always somebody who has to take the fall for it, and it's usually the poorer countries. So the effects of the economic wealth is largely taken up by others, which are in the poorest communities. And with the scenarios that I'm showing, it's going to be India and the US. So in India, 51% of the pollution in India is industrialization. And you notice in when you think of pollution, it's mostly in small and poorest countries like India. And India has experienced a huge global loss of 26.2% when globally it's 18.1%, and that's compared to US, which is 4.27%. And India and the US doesn't even differ in size, only differ in size and wealth, and that shows how much it impacts. And in the US another comparison is that in the US we have the most CO2 emissions as in 2019. So the second way is fast economic growth will only promote environmental damage. So this relates to my first claim, because when you think of economic wealth, it usually is struck by fast growth in the economy. So this is only possible by using natural resources, and fast economic growth will only result in mass production, which means more industries, more pollution, more air pollution. This promotes an unbalanced equality, and the example of this is China and the US. So in the graph, this represents the unbalanced equality, as up the top, this side up the top is environmental damage, and going this way is the economic growth. So this line represents the economy as we go up, we start making more money, we use more resources, until we reach the turning point. And we reach the turning point, we use the most amount of resources without thinking about the effects, and we have a very nice amount of money, and as we go down in time, we use less resources because we use them all up, but we still make more money. So in China and the US, China has experienced 2 decades worth of fast economic growth, bringing wealth to the country and citizens. However, this growth is the cost of it is the environment. So in China, there's 27% of global emissions, and this is also from urbanization. And this is the picture up here is from Beijing, and this side represents before the 2 decades and after the 2 decades. And this is the air pollution currently now. So with urbanization, they experience a lot of air and water pollution. And as in 2017, there's 50 million people without actual clean air and water. And with this environmental problem, they are now experiencing a drop in GDP by 3%. And in the US, our country has rooted from the crude oil industry, and we generate heating, electricity, and plastics and make $1 billion from it. But the effects of it, but as citizens, we also use it by traveling and by buying cheaper goods and by the effects. However, this is also concerning environmental damage because it tarnishes ecosystems, sea forests, erosion, oil spills, air pollution, and wasteful plastics. And this shows that economic growth and environmental security cannot be accomplished in the same time. So the third way is consumer sovereignty overrules environmental health. So the economy is driven by what they get from a profit, and they will exploit the earth for any way how to get the profit. And the next slide, I'll be showing you an example of how that works, and that's with mobile phones. So mobile phones, they're very popular and they're used by everyone, and they make a lot of money from this. And this is the making of them, software installing, testing phase, mass production, packaging, and shipping. What they don't tell you in the making of it is that we have to exploit the resources, and when we do that, we use metals and we use a lot of air. We're not a lot of air, but a lot of elements that we shouldn't be using. And when we do that, it brings toxins and a lot of air pollution. And with the ecosystem destruction, we try to get the rare resources, we mine, or we clear off the land and we try to mine it. And when we do that, we destroy habitats and there's a lot of habitat loss. And because plastic mine waste spills, that's always a possibility of it. And this picture, this picture is from Colorado, but the biggest land spill was in Brazil, and it killed 19 people and reached the Atlantic Ocean in 70 days. So reflection, as individuals, we can try to maintain a balance and be more sensible of our outputs, and we should be more careful and know that what we do and what we buy also affects the earth. The limitations that we can't expect any progress along the course of the economy considering the drive. The conclusion is that the economy and consumer wants is the driving force of what we see in the current environmental damage, and it may be common and ideal for assessing how we need to understand and interpret the connection between us, the economy, and the environment.
Good on the timing too.